Whilst I just generally like Arch Linux because it's lightweight by default, it only installs the packages that I want to install, not a bunch of other pre-installed nonsense that I'm never going to use. Arch isn't the only distro like this though. I could use Gentoo or Void Linux or a bunch of others. The reason why I stick with Arch is because of the Arch user repository, the AUR. Most of the time, even if there isn't a package on anything else, there's usually an AUR package, if not made by the developer, just made by some random fan of the application. However, whilst it should be obvious from the name, AUR, Arch User Repository, it can very easily be forgotten that the AUR is specifically for Arch Linux and Arch Linux only, not Endeavor, not Manjaro, not CatchyOS, Arch Linux. These other distros that are based on Arch are completely free to use the AUR. They use Pac-Man, they use the same build system, they can go and use the AUR as well. But there's absolutely zero expectation that anything on the AUR is going to work on anything besides Arch Linux. Even then, there's no expectation it's actually going to work on Arch Linux anyway. But most people using something Arch-based pretty much just know this, especially if we're talking something like Manjaro, which is Arch-based but doesn't follow the same Arch-based update cycle. They release things at a different rate, and dependencies in the AUR are based upon what Arch Linux has. So there have been a number of times where packages didn't build, packages behaved weirdly, and just generally, it's not recommended to use the AUR if you're on Manjaro. But where this becomes a lot more of a problem that is a lot less often discussed is the kinds of systems supported by packages on the AUR. So modern Arch Linux is an x86 64-bit distro. This means you need a relatively normal desktop or laptop CPU from like the past 20 or so years. If you have an AMD or Intel CPU, you're pretty much just fine. So not an ARM-based chip like you would see in a phone or an Apple Silicon device, and not a 32-bit x86 chip like you would see in devices from like a couple decades back. So there are distros that are separate from Arch, but based on Arch, that provide things like 32-bit x86 support or ARM support. And these are relatively important projects in the general Arch Linux ecosystem. But importantly, these are separate distros from Arch Linux itself. And by creating this separation, it makes a bit of an issue for the AUR, because whilst they are technically under the banner of Arch Linux, they're not Arch Linux itself, the x86 64-bit distro. So should packages that only support Arch Linux ARM or Arch Linux 32 actually be allowed on the Arch user repository? Well, it's not a major concern, but it is something that did come up over on the Arch Linux mailing list, where there were packages that basically got removed. There was a package made for U-Boot CM3588 NAS, which did exist at this link here. Not anymore, though. And at the time, the AUR submission guidelines weren't entirely clear on the matter whether or not a non-x86 64 package should be allowed on the AUR or not. At the time, the closest mention was this right here. I don't know why it's trying to turn this into a part of the link. Whatever. Anyway, under Section 10 Architectures, the Arch array, that being the architecture array, should contain x86_64 if the compiled package is architecture specific. Otherwise, use any for architecture independent packages. So if it supports anything, that's fine. But if it only supports a single thing, it should say x86-64. This is kind of implying that single architecture packages should be only for the 64-bit x86 version. But it's not entirely clear, it's not in the submission guidelines, and there are plenty of cases where documentation just isn't as comprehensive as it should be. So my question is, are packages for other architectures allowed in the AUR? Also, in light of recent discussions around Arch Linux ports, I think it would be helpful to spell out the answer to this question explicitly in the AUR submission guidelines. So this is basically a testing ground for different unsupported architectures. I don't know why it's taking so long to load. Different unsupported architectures from what Arch Linux currently has. So if this continues going further, then you'd have people trying things out in the AUR, even though it's not technically officially allowed. So explicitly saying this is what we're doing makes that clear from the start. Now, following this, there was a reply from the person who took down the package itself, Bert Peters. As the person who accepted the deletion request in question, I feel I should comment on this. This, in regards to what sort of architectures are allowed on the AUR, is a good question, and one to which the answer needs to be written down and consistently answered. My understanding of the policy as it exists now is based on this section of the submission guidelines. The AUR and official repositories are intended for packages which install general software and software-related content, including one or more of the following: executables, configuration files, online or offline documentation for specific software, or the Arch Linux distribution as a whole, media intended to be used directly by software. The crux here is for the Arch Linux distribution. Packages in the AUR should be useful on Arch Linux, which is currently an x86-64 only distribution. We're not talking something like Debian, which supports a million different architectures, many of which you don't use because no one uses them because it's ancient legacy hardware. However, it's still supported. Software that doesn't work on that architecture therefore shouldn't be in the AUR, as it is not for Arch Linux, even if it may be useful for Arch Linux derivatives. Now, that doesn't mean you couldn't have a package for it, but that package can't be in the AUR. It should be in some other third-party repository. In the same vein, the AUR isn't for personal packages, so even if it's not popular, a package should be on the AUR if another person could find some use for it. So yes, there is like a million different terminals and fetch applications and system monitors, and you could argue there doesn't need to be this many of them, but they might have a use to another person. But if it's like personal dot files or a fork that doesn't actually change anything, that doesn't belong on the AUR. That does not mean your package build may not support other architectures. On the contrary, with the various ports out there, it makes sense to share your existing package builds. There is nothing that prevents you from adding additional architecture support to your architecture array, or even sources specifically for different architectures, as long as it also works for x86-64. So if you want to have this, and you also want to have ARM, and you want to have 32-bit, you want to have this, you want to have that, totally fine. But the main one must be there. Arch Linux, in my opinion, should not be hosting arbitrary package builds for any distro that might want to host user scripts somewhere. Requiring package builds to be useful for Arch while allowing other architectures to be supported seems like a reasonable compromise. As a final note, there is talk of eventually supporting more architectures for Arch Linux. Should that day come, the AUR may of course host package builds for those architectures specifically. I do hope we get there. Now, if that ever does happen, I'd be curious to see if having a package only for, let's say they support ARM, only for ARM, or only for x86-64 would be allowed then, or if the package is on the AUR, if it would have to support everything that could reasonably be supported. Now, the package author respected this opinion, but didn't necessarily agree with it, but hey, if that's the way it's gonna be, it is what it is. However, if that is going to be the way it is, could the submission guidelines actually be updated to make it very, very clear to ensure this problem never happens again in the future, so everybody submitting a package is completely aware of what architectures are supported? Now, related to this is the FEX project. This is an emulator to run x86 or x86-64 code on an ARM64 system. For obvious reasons, this requires an ARM64 system and doesn't work on x86-64. Imagine that. Now, they did have a package over on the AUR as well. However, this issue or this pull request was also made. Remove Arch from the release process. So a deletion request was made on their package, and as the rules would entail, the package got removed. Now, in the case of FEX, the AUR was actually an officially supported platform in the project. It wasn't just like, hey, we, you know, have this random thing that somebody made a package, which is the way it happens for a lot of things. But in this case, they were actually the ones managing the package, and, you know, the rules are the rules, right? They're not annoyed by it. They're just like, yeah, this is the way it is now. We're just going to document this in the project so we know why it's the case, and then just go ahead and remove it. Now, hopefully, this problem is completely resolved and isn't going to happen again because the submission guidelines have been updated. This one right here, packages that do not support the x86-64 architecture are not allowed in the AUR, linking over to the discussion over on the Arch Linux. Jesus Christ, this takes forever to load. Mailing list. Yeah, this might be annoying for those developers that had a package on the AUR, but it's much better for it to be completely clear on what the rules are. You'd much rather that than like, oh, we're going to remove this package, but not this package, and the guidelines are just completely hit and miss. Nobody wants to deal with that. This is the better stance to take. What do you think? Do you think packages not specifically for Arch should be allowed on the AUR? Do you think it should be a place to find packages for Arch-based distros, not just Arch Linux? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, and LiberoPay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and Arch is the best distro. It's just flat out true.